Hey, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to give you the ultimate guide to WordPress shortcodes. WordPress shortcodes are a powerful feature to do cool stuff with little effort. You can do pretty much anything with them. With shortcodes, embedding interactive elements or creating complex page layouts is as easy as inserting a single line of code. Shortcodes eliminate the need for complicated scripts and allow you to add dynamic content effortlessly. In this video, we will go over WordPress shortcode basics. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. And take note, there's a lot of code snippets in this video, so we have made them available in the video description below so you can copy and paste them later. All right, let's get started. In a nutshell, shortcode equals shortcut plus code. Typically, shortcodes use square bracket tags to define how they're used. Each shortcode performs a particular function in a site. It can be as simple as formatting the content or as complex as defining the entire website structure. For example, you can use shortcodes to embed sliders, forms, or pricing tables. You can even use them to create reusable page design templates. There are primarily two types of shortcodes in WordPress: self-closing shortcodes, these don't need a closing tag, and enclosing shortcodes, these need a closing tag. Enclosing shortcodes generally manipulate the content between the opening and closing tags. WordPress comes with six default shortcodes. First is audio. Embed audio files on your website. It includes simple playback controls like play and pause. Caption. Wrap captions around your content with it. It's mostly used to add image captions, but you can use it for any HTML element. Embed. Expand on the default O embed feature. This shortcode lets you set different attributes to your embeds, like setting their max dimensions. Gallery. Insert a simple image gallery on your site. You can use attributes to define which images are used and customize how the gallery looks. Playlist. Display a collection of audio or video files with the self-enclosing shortcode. You can give it a cool dark mode with its style attribute. Video. Embed a video file and play it back using a simple video player. This shortcode supports embedding videos with these formats: MP4, WebM, M4V, OGV, WMV, and FLV. First, go to the page and post editor where you want to insert the shortcode. If you're using the Gutenberg editor, you can add the shortcode tag in the standalone shortcode block. You can find it in the Widgets section. Still using the classic editor, you can type in your shortcode tags the classic way. A few shortcodes may even have a button in the editor screen to insert them readily. Shortcodes can also be inserted in sidebar widgets. To add them, go to Appearance, then Widgets, and add a text widget to the section where you want to add the shortcut. Paste the shortcode inside the text widget and save it. You can visit your site's front end and see the shortcode's output in your sidebar. WordPress shortcodes are generally meant for pages, posts, and widgets. But here's an easy way to insert shortcodes anywhere on your site. Say you want to add a call to action button in your footer, or in all of your posts before the comments section. The Do shortcode callback function comes in handy here. You need to add the following code to your theme's header PHP file, footer PHP file, or any of its template files. This will output the shortcode in the place where you insert the code. You need to include the square brackets in between the quotation marks to echo the shortcode. Just including its name won't work. Likewise, you can use the Do shortcode callback function to enable shortcodes anywhere in WordPress, like in the comments section. The WordPress shortcode API defines how you can use shortcodes to customize and expand your site's functionality. It enables developers to create unique content like forms, carousels, and sliders that users can add in their sites by pasting the relevant shortcode. You can add almost any feature you can imagine to your website with the help of shortcodes. The API supports both self-closing and enclosing shortcodes. It handles all the tricky parsing and includes helper functions to set and fetch default attributes. Thanks to the API, you can dive straight into developing and customizing shortcodes rather than waste precious time defining regular expressions for every shortcode you make. Every time you open a page or post in WordPress, it looks for registered shortcodes while processing the site's content. If a registered shortcode is found, the shortcode API takes over and returns the output of the shortcodes. The returned output string replaces the shortcode tag in the location it was added. You register a shortcode in WordPress with the add shortcode function. Here's how it's done. Shortcode name is the tag WordPress will look for while parsing post content. The shortcode API recommends you use only lowercase letters, numbers, and underscores to define its value. Try to avoid dashes. Shortcode handler function is the callback function that will be executed after WordPress confirms the presence of a registered shortcode. The shortcode handler function is defined as such. The parameter ATTS is an associative array of attributes, for example, an array of key value pairs. If you define no attributes, it will default to an empty string. The parameter content is the enclosed content if you're defining an enclosing shortcode. It is the responsibility of the handler function to ensure the content value is returned to the output. The tag parameter is the shortcode's tag value. If two or more shortcodes share the same callback function, which is valid, the tag value will help you determine which shortcode triggered the handler function. The API parses the shortcode's tag, attributes, and enclosed content, if any, by bypassing the values to the handler function, which processes them and returns an output string. This output string replaces the shortcode macro on your site's front end. What you ultimately see in the browser is the output. You can add your custom shortcode scripts to the theme's functions.php file, or include them in a plugin. If you're adding it to a theme file, you can run the add shortcode function as is. But if you're adding it to a plugin, I recommend that you initialize it only after WordPress has loaded completely. You can ensure that by wrapping the add shortcode function with another function. This is called a wrapper function. The add action function hooks the shortcode's init function to fire only after WordPress has finished loading. Be sure to check out our other video, how to create custom WordPress shortcodes here. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.